Hello guys, welcome to the tutorial for RNP Baro-VNAV approach using IAN for 737. Then we summarize the types of approaches and how they are classified within the PVN concept. Currently the approaches are classified according to the approaching minima. Type A with minimums greater than or equal to 250 feet and type B with minimums less than or equal to 250 feet. In type A, we have no precision approaches within the group called 2D with only lateral guide. Here we find the BOR log, NDB and log approaches. Within the 2D approaches, we have an RNP approach based only on lateral guidance, which we can fly with LNAV on the 737. This approach is considered a non-precision approach and the CVFA technique will be used. Within the PVN concept and considered as approaches with 3D lateral and vertical guidance are the new approaches called APV. Here we find the RNP approach Baro-VNAV. As can we see, it's not considered either non-precision or precision approach. Within the APV approaches, we have the RNP approach called LPV, where the minimums are reduced. This type of approach requires a special equipment on board to be able to tune into the ECNOS channel associated with that approach. This is basically a GNSS signal augmentation system that allows greater precision. As can you see in this example for Palma de Mallorca in the approach published for runway 06 left, it can be seen that the chart already specifies that it's in an LPV approach with ECNOS channel associated with this approach. However, nowadays, most 737 currently flying do not have this onboard equipment for LPV approaches, in exception of the planes that have version 14.0 installed in the FMC and multi-mode receiver equipment on board. Of course, on 737 MAX, sure they will have this feature indeed. In our case, for Air Europa Virtual Fleet, are not able to fly with this type of approaches. About precision approach, besides already known ILS CAT 1, 2 and 3 approaches, we also have an LPV approach considered precision approach, called LPV CAT 1 or LPV 200, which nowadays equals the minimums for CAT 1. One more time, the Air Europa Virtual Fleet is not able to fly in this type of approach. And finally, excluded from the PVN concept, we have the GLS approaches, but in Europe there are not many airports with these systems for the moment. In this case, Air Europa Virtual is able to fly GLS approaches if your aircraft has appropriate multi-mode receiver equipment on board. In this case, no longer be the ECNOS channel, but GBS channel. It is basically a combination of augmented GNSS signal and ground antenna that helps to update the position of the aircraft with high precision. In simulation, this system for now only available in, is available in 737 or SIBO, while if you fly PMDG, you cannot enjoy them for the moment. Once the summary is done, in this video we are going to focus on the RNP approach Baro-VNAV down to LNAV-VNAV minima, and we will also use the EIN capability of our 737. Always we expected the possibility of making an RNP approach, we will check that we have the minimum equipment on board and is fully operational. Also we have in the flight plan the suffix S2 in the PVN section. Database is up to date. RNP approaches are in the database. There is no time affected to the RNP approaches procedures. During the design preparation, we will verify that the GNSS is used as sensor system for navigation. We can see that on the progress page on the FMC, nav status, and the second page. we must check that the GPS update is on. We will select the legs page and we verify that the selected RNP approach procedure is OK, checking it with the approach chart. To do this, we will also select the plan mode in the navigation display, and with the step function of the FMC, we will check the sequence of waypoints, tracks, distance, and final approach glide path. During the initial approach, it is possible that the ATC gives to us direct vectors. During the initial approach, it is possible that ATC gives to us direct vectors from initial approach fix to intermediate fix. However, we must consider some limitations. First, direct vectors to the intermediate fix are accepted if the distance between the final approach fix and the intermediate fix is greater than 2 miles. Second, intersecting angle is not greater than 45 degrees respect to the final approach track. By the way, in this case, as can we see from river to Nico, this condition is not complying. We could calculate the angle from the initial approach fix to intermediate fix using the FMC and checking what track offers. And we observe we have 58 degrees of track. If we subtract 3 degrees from the final approach course, we have an angle of 55 degrees, obviously higher than the 45 degrees required. So in this case, direct to new go from river would not be possible. Other thing to consider is that the directs to the final approach fix are not allowed. Well, there is another limitation for Baro-VNAV approaches. Altimeter corrections for low temperatures. Altimeter errors occur at very low temperatures. When the temperature is colder than the standard, the true altitude is lower than indicated. So the altimeter error can be significant. We must check the limited temperature on the chart in order to safely proceed with this approach. In this case, we can see the limit is 15 degrees below zero. However, the Baro-VNAV approach has a special characteristic. If the outside temperature is within the limits indicated on the approach chart, it's not necessary to apply the altitude corrections to the final approach fix or decision altitude. But we have to apply to the other altitudes affected in the procedure, like MCA or the missed approach altitude. You can find the altimeter correction table in the 737-FCOM in the supplementary procedure section in adverse weather and cold temperature. During the approach briefing, once we have applied the corrections to the altitudes, if any, we will select the LNAV-VNAV minimums. Remember, don't make mistake and select the LPV minimums. In this case, for this approach, our minimums will be 330 feet. Other important topic to take into account is to determine if we are going to do the approach with the integrated approach navigation mode or not. Currently, all 737s with update 10.5 or higher already have this capability integrated. and its use is recommended for APB approach, even for non-precision ones. Basically, the IIN capability converts the horizontal and vertical indications of the LNAV and VNAV modes in ILS lookalike, which really facilitates the interpretation of the indications, alerts, and standardizations of procedures and training of the crew, being the presentation similar than ILS in the PFDE. Here can we see how the information of a conventional ILS approach is represented, with the flight model annunciator VOR log and glide slope mode. If we make an APV Baro-VNAV approach without the use of IIN, we have a different presentation than the ILS with NPS, vertical and lateral scales. The LNAV lateral and VNAV path vertical modes will also appear in the flight model annunciator, and we will not have an indication of distance to the threshold. Doing the same Baro-VNAV approach with IIN, simply activating approach on the MCP, as can we see, the presentation is similar to ILS, converting the NPS indicators into localizer and glide slope deviation pointers. In this case, it's the FMC who sends the deviations to the flight director with the autopilot activated. The type of approach and distance to the threshold will be shown as well, and the flight mode annunciator also indicate final approach course and glide path modes. On the final intercept course, we arm approach in MCP. So in the flight mode annunciator, we will see the final approach course and glide path modes in white. When intercepting, the lateral scale becomes a scale similar to ILS. And in the flight mode annunciator, we will see the final approach course mode activated. Intercepting the glide path, the same thing will happen. The scale is modified and the glide path mode is activated in the flight mode annunciator. Now the plane is ready to fly to minimums. Back to our approach to Amsterdam. The minimum to perform an RNP approach is 0.3 miles lateral and 125 vertical feet. Below 10,000 feet, we have to modify the RNP vertical to 125 feet, since by default the FMC selects 400 feet. We do this on page 4 on progress on the FMC. In this type of approach, it is recommended to intercept the glide path with at least flaps 5 and match speed, in order to comply with the profile that VNAV has calculated. Remember that the vertical profile in the 737 is quite complicated to manage.
Bears and level.
Once clear for the approach, and with less than 90 degrees of interception angle, approach must be selected on the MCP, and the final approach course and glide path modes will turn to armed, and must be checked in the flight mode annunciator.
Cabin crew, take your seats.
For RNP approach, we must use only one autopilot. When intercepting the final approach course, the runway heading will be selected on the MCP, and check the final approach course mode on the flight mode annunciator. Gear down, plus 15, course capture,
Gear down. Speed check to flaps 15.
Flaps 30.
Speed checked. Flaps 30.
Path capture. Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Engine start switches.
Continuous.
Speed brake.
Armed.
Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
30 green light.
Landing checklist complete.
Wipers on.
Wipers coming on.
Thousand feet.
Stabilized vital items. Disconnecting.
Stable. Checked.
Approaching minimums.
Checked.
Minimum.
Inside. Continue.
Check. Runway. Reverse is normal. Sixty knots. Auto brake disarm.
Until the seatbelt signs are turned off. Take care when opening overhead lockers, as items may have moved.